to perform a multitude of peaceful tasks for the betterment of mankind. Man is exploring a source of enormous, potentially useful energy, the nuclear explosion.
Wait, what? Nuclear explosions for the betterment of mankind? What does that even mean? The answer has to do with the first ever use of the atomic bomb in World War II, and the human desire to find some good in something so new and destructive. 75 years ago, a group of scientists at the University of Chicago carried out the first nuclear reaction. Their work led to this. For many people, nuclear explosives are associated with images like these. But after the war, the U.S. tried to find ways to use the power of nuclear reactions in a productive way. The government created a handful of initiatives to put the power of so-called peaceful nuclear explosions to use for everything from digging canals to space exploration. The biggest one was called Plowshare, and we're not even joking. It was basically an effort to replace TNT with nuclear explosives. Engineers thought nuclear devices could be a more cost-effective way to clear land, mine for metals, and drill for oil and gas. The name was lifted from a passage in the Bible. They will beat their swords into plowshares. Robert Rossner, a theoretical physicist at the University of Chicago, explains what the government was trying to do.
So the whole point was to turn the public perception about things nuclear away from the weapons program and toward civilian applications that would clearly be perceived by the general public as a positive thing.
So in 1961, plowshare scientists started experiments at the National Nuclear Weapons Test Site near Las Vegas. The site covers a huge area, roughly the size of Rhode Island. During the plowshare program, it was known for being
the valley where the giant mushrooms grow.
Scientists were testing whether nukes could safely work for giant construction projects. Edward Teller, one of the creators of the hydrogen bomb, was a major plowshare supporter. He summed it up like this: if your mountain is not in the right place, drop us a card. From 1958 until 1975, scientists set off over 24 nuclear explosions to study their cratering effects. One of the largest nuclear excavation experiments was a 1962 explosion that created the Sedan crater. The cloud rose 100 feet in the air, blasting away 12 million tons of Earth.
A 100 kiloton nuclear cratering detonation.
Jack Doyle, who was a contractor on a number of plowshare projects, says,
every time that one of these underground things went off, you certainly did get noticeable ground motion. You could definitely feel it here in Las Vegas, and in fact, the routine when they did that kind of testing was they would notify the high-rise hotels here in town at that time of an impending test.
Plowshare scientists also used nuclear explosives to stimulate oil and gas drilling. They used a method similar to those developed later for hydraulic fracking.
3, 2, 1, fire!
Of course, plowshare projects never made it past the testing phase.
And so one of the obvious questions is, okay, so if you use a bomb to do excavation, are you going to contaminate the site to the point where it's actually not usable?
Members of the public certainly thought so. They worried about health risks. Eventually, the general fear of all things nuclear led to plowshare's demise in 1975. But the experiments proved helpful in at least a few ways. NASA used some of the blast craters to train Apollo astronauts for moon expeditions and found ways to power spacecraft with nuclear energy. And just because scientists didn't find a peaceful use for nuclear explosives here on Earth, it doesn't mean they won't find them elsewhere.
Eventually, you can transform Mars into an Earth-like planet. The fast way is drop thermonuclear weapons over the poles.